from at Stirling Castle. I mean, the car park. £4. It's pretty well full, the car park, so this is still the middle of the winter. There's Stirling Castle out there. Of course, it is mid-term, so a lot of people do take their holidays. And unfortunately, it's a gloomy day, a misty day, so I don't know if you can see. There's Wallace Monument. Now, it's an imposing structure. I don't think I'm going to see that today, but and of course it's up on a hilltop, about 300 feet above the valley here. Silhouette stock cop picture. King Robert the Bruce. Had a meal, feeling a bit better. And there's the castle. Repulse Cromwell's forces, apparently. Yeah, the sun's coming out, but I don't know if you can see. It's just Wallace Monument, just over in the distance. Smallwork Gatehouse. The grand entrance to James the Fourth's castle. Castle looks as though it's pretty, it wasn't demolished like a lot of English castles. I've only just started the tour of this castle. The Overport Battery. Emplacement for, well, quite a few guns to defend. The castle against an attack from the town. These cannon could hurl a cannonball about a mile inside the constable's tower. It was largely demolished in the English Civil Wars, which overflowed into Scotland. The royalty, I think, was supported generally in Scotland against Cromwell's forces. The kitchens. Well, the sun's gone for quite a bit of reconstructing the kitchen staff. Almost lifelike. It's about 5'10" tall. Spend at least 2 hours around this castle, maybe longer, exploring all the nooks and crannies. An extensive cemetery. Right there. It's pretty about the day. It's gloomy, overcast, and misty. This is the entrance to the exhibition room, model of the Great Hall. Of information here. Apparently glass was used as early as the Romans, but someone else audio demonstration. Interesting part of the castle. The buildings, the palace for the royalty when they stay here. The ladies' lookout. Where the ladies at the Royal Court stood to admire the view. Unfortunately, there's not much of a view today. And the Wallace Monument has disappeared from view. Over there is the site of the Battle of Bannockburn. There certainly was enough cannons defending this castle. There's a good view of the rocky rampart that the castle was built on. The Birdman of Stirling. He leapt over the wall there and had a broken leg for his pains. Stirling Palace entrance. No one in here. That's unusual. Place myself. This is where the royalty wined and dined. Regimental Museum there. Scaffolding work on the roof. Chapel Royal. Almost had this place to myself. Someone coming in. Fully restored. Services were held here quite recently and may still be held, judging by all the chairs around. The Regimental Museum. Douglas Gardens and we'll walk through here. Men of the Royals and nobility came to a sticky end. Regimental dining room. Majesty. She came to the... came to here. Oh, that's the Moral Castle. Royalty. Presenting the colours. To the 9th Battalion. And that was painted by the Princess Louise herself. Hopefully there are no screaming kids in this neck of the woods. Car park down there. It was used as the parade ground when this was the regimental headquarters. It is, still pretty misty, but you can just about make out the Wallace Monument up on that hill there in the middle distance.